In this N-Track video, we're going to talk about quantizing MIDI in the N-Track Studio app. For those of you that don't know what quantizing is, when we record MIDI instruments, there can often be rhythmic imperfections. Quantizing allows us to tighten these imperfections up. Let's run through it together. We'll start by adding the Steinway Bright piano instrument you can find within N-Track. I'm recording this directly into the app using a USB piano keyboard. Let's listen back and see how it sounds. Rhythmically, it's not bad, but it's not perfect. Let's use the Quantize tool to tighten it up. So we'll return to the main window. In the top left, you'll see the grid tool. We're going to use this to choose how we want to quantize the MIDI. There's a bunch of options relating to different rhythmic values. Let's select a beat for this example and compare with another value after. To add quantizing to the MIDI, let's go back into the piano roll, press and hold a note, select all as we want to quantize all of the notes, repress and select quantize. You may have noticed as we pressed quantize, the MIDI note shifted to the nearest beat. That's because we selected beat in the grid tool. So let's play the tightened up MIDI. Here's the MIDI unquantized. So again, not bad, it just sounds looser. Now let's quantize the same MIDI with a different rhythmic value. We'll select measure and see how it sounds. Again, we'll return to the piano roll, press and hold a MIDI note, select all, press again, and quantize. The MIDI notes have moved pretty dramatically because they've latched onto the nearest measure. You might be able to tell what's coming. So it sounds like a mess. By quantizing, latching onto the nearest measure, the music has lost its rhythmic identity. So be careful not to quantize to a rhythmic value that's too broad for the music that you're writing. Let's listen again to the MIDI with the beat rhythmic value selected. Normality is restored. Let's add a melody to these chords and explore quantizing that as well. So we'll add a MIDI instrument track, piano and keys, electric piano, and Rhodes Bright. That sound should work well with the piano. Let's activate the metronome at 120 BPM and press record. Okay, let's listen back to that. A bit loose at the start there. Let's zoom in and listen back. So the first MIDI note is not on beat, and other melody MIDI notes are loose as well. So let's quantize the melody. We selected beat for the MIDI piano chords because, well, they were always played on beat. Eighth notes are used in this melody, so we're going to select eight. Let's return to the piano roll, and we can see that on the grid, the vertical lines are now divided into eighth notes. Let's quantize this melody line. There you go. They've snapped to the nearest eighth note, and this is going to sound more precise. So that's the melody and the chords. Let's round this arrangement out by adding some bass. We'll add another MIDI track, an instrument track, and we'll go to synths, vintage synth, and select lead oct. Not every bass note was bang on in terms of timing. We're going to need to quantize, and the timing of that first note was bugging me. In the grid selection tool, there's also the option to choose straight, dotted, or triplet rhythm types. As the bass is quite static, we're going to stay with straight. The bass notes were on beat, so we're going to select the beat option. Again, we'll go into the piano roll and quantize the MIDI notes. Their positions will shift slightly, as you can see. Let's listen to the tightened up version. Final version of the track is coming up. We've made one addition, which is to duplicate the melody that was played on the Rhodes, the MIDI, to another track. We've used a synth called Lead 2 that you can find in the N-Track Studio app. As always, thanks for watching. Any questions, please leave them in the comments below. We hope you've learned about how to use the Quantize tool in N-Track. Until next time.